Right, hello again everybody. In this video we're going to continue our discussion of the determinant of a matrix or determinants of matrices, but we're going to discuss specifically the case of finding the determinant of a 3x3 matrix, which is fundamentally different of course from finding the determinant of a 2x2 matrix, but it is a special case that we can use a kind of a unique pattern that occurs with 3x3s. As in the previous video, we used a unique pattern that occurred with 2x2s. And I have to tell you this, this pattern does not exist for 4x4s and above. Of course, what we typically show people is how to find the determinant of a matrix, a square matrix in general, by using expansion with minors and cofactors. But in this video, since a 3x3 is so special, we can actually present a special instance. So instead of, as in the last video, showing you kind of a generalization over here on the right, what I'm going to do instead, rather, is just kind of hook you up with the pattern here and kind of walk through how you might necessarily find the determinant of a 3x3 matrix, okay? So let's go ahead and start by taking into consideration this matrix A here, this square matrix A. And you'll notice it is a 3x3 square matrix, but we want to find its determinant. So in terms of grammar, just how you write this, it's very consistent with what we've done always, but we write the determinant of a matrix as the capital letter denoting this matrix, or the matrix itself, but inside these absolute value bars, okay? So anytime you see these absolute value bars, we're discussing the determinant of a matrix. So you'll see here, we can just go ahead and re-scribble this. We say 0, 2, 1 in the first row. 3, negative 1, and 2 in the second row, and then 4, 0, and 1 in the third, okay? But the fact of the matter is this, I'm going to have to switch colors on you here. How about we go with maybe a darker green tint here? But what I'm going to do is, in order to find the determinant of this matrix, you know, with 2x2s, what we ended up doing was we took the product of the main diagonal, those three numbers, and we subtracted off the product of the opposing diagonal, okay? But in this instance, we can't just get away with doing that. We actually have to do several different things here. So what we're going to do instead is, I'm going to have us first with the 3x3 matrix. We're going to take these two columns right here. So this column right here and this column right here. And we're going to actually extend them off to the right-hand side over here. So what we're essentially doing is copying and pasting those first two columns off to the right-hand side. And you'll see why here in just a moment. But we say 2, negative 1, and 0, okay? I'm going to go ahead and do another color switch here. How about we go a lighter red that we can see it. But what we're going to end up doing here is necessarily this. We are going to find the products of the main diagonals here, plural. But it's going to be done in an interesting fashion. So the first thing we're going to do is this. We are going to find the product of what you would have considered the main diagonal in the first place. Now the nice thing about this is, you know, you consider the product of this, of course, negative 1 times 1 is negative 1, but you'll notice we have a 0 in here, which is actually quite a boon because we can just consider that as being a 0, okay? So you're going to notice I'm going to write the determinant of A down here, and I'm going to start organizing things, but I'm going to drop in some brackets, and the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to write the product of this main diagonal, which ended up being 0, okay? So we're going to take 0, and we're actually going to add this product to now the product of the next, I don't want to call it the main diagonal, okay, but the next, you know, forward going diagonal here. So we say 2 times 2, which is 4, and 4 times 4 is 16. We're going to take that product, and we're going to add it to the product of the first main diagonal there. So, and then and to finish this up here, we're going to find the product of this last diagonal over here, which, again, you're going to notice it's kind of nice that there's a 0 here, but 1 times 3 times 0 is just 0, okay? So now that we've found the product of these first, you know, foregoing diagonals, we're gonna quantify that. So you say 0 plus 16 plus 0, we end up with just a sum of 16. But what I want to do is generalize this. So this first, you know, quantity here is no more than the sum of the products of the first three forward-going diagonals. Now, what we're going to do is, kind of like the last video when we found the determinant of a 2x2, we're going to subtract off a product here, but the sum of the products, rather, and I'm going to switch colors again just to really emphasize this, and what we'll do is, how about we go with a light blue here? Kind of feel like Bob Ross, but, and what we're going to do is subtract off the products of the three opposing diagonals. So it's kind of like the mirror image of what we had rocking here, but basically we're going to go backwards here. So if I mentioned the opposing diagonals, this would be the example, the first example of the first opposing diagonal, but we're going to find the product of this diagonal here, and we're going to do this here. We'll drop in a parenthesis, but we say 2 times 3 times 1 ends up with a product of 6, okay? 6, and we'll write plus the product of this now, this next opposing diagonal here, and you notice it's nice. We actually have two zeros here, but product of 0 in it is just merely 0, and then we'll sum that with the product of the last opposing diagonal. So now you've got 4 times negative 1, which is negative 4, times positive 1, which is, you know, still negative 4. But adding these all together, now you're going to notice we have something here that says 6 basically minus 4, or 6 plus a negative 4, but ends up with a sum of 2. I'm sorry to just kind of switch colors on you here, but this whole idea that the determinant of this ends up being 16 minus 2, which ends up with just a number of 14, which actually happens to be the determinant of this 3x3 matrix, which you'll notice is not 0. So we can consider this a non-singular matrix. Non-singular, which is actually cool, which, you know, it means a few things. It means that, well, we're going to go into the collinearity. I don't know how you'd say that. You know, 3 points involved with this matrix would be collinear, and as a matter of fact, it's set up wrong. When we go over this in a further video, you'll understand. But we can say this. Since the matrix is non-singular, it must imply that it does have an inverse, or an inverse, a unique inverse must exist for this matrix. So again, just to kind of review this, when you find the inverse of a 3x3 matrix, of course, we're going to take this first two columns here, we're going to copy it and paste it off to the right-hand side, you know, no matter what 3x3 matrix you're given. Copy and paste those off to the right-hand side, but you're going to find the product, the sum of the products of the first three main diagonals here. And sorry, that's so sloppy. And you're going to take that sum and subtract off the sum of the products of the three opposing diagonals, okay? And this, in the sense of a 3x3 matrix, will always yield its determinant. So it's worth noting that this special pattern exists. So, and...